Hello. So I am a specialist in HubSpot for conversion tracking. So I, for example, offer the conversion tracking service where you can just hire me and in about 1 hour I will track your HubSpot form conversions, Google Ads, Google Analytics, Metapixel, and anything else, TikTok. I have also written a few tutorials about this. I'll actually need to update the code and everything. But yeah, I know how to do HubSpot form conversion tracking. So this is my new product, not a service, but a product that will help you track your HubSpot form conversions. So basically, what it is, it's this JSON file which you can import to Google Tag Manager very easily. Just by clicking on import container, then choose the file, click open, just go through this, click merge, doesn't really matter, and then click confirm. So, in about 10 seconds, we have imported the whole HubSpot form conversion tracking setup into my Google Tag Manager. It has all the listeners, JavaScript, tags, and instructions included. So let me demonstrate this. I'm gonna click preview. And now we see our website, the tag assistant. I have gone to Google Analytics, the real-time view, just because I want to show you the conversion being tracked. I also have the Facebook test events page open here so I can see. All right, so let's submit the HubSpot form. And now the conversions are being tracked just with that quick little import. So let's take a look. In the Google Tag Assistant, the HubSpot form success, this is the trigger that comes with my setup. So that was fired correctly. And it fired these tags: the Google Ads tag, Metapixel lead version, Metapixel contact version. You can choose which one you like, which one you prefer, and the Google Analytics 4 event for the HubSpot form. All right, so here we can actually see in real time the HubSpot form with this ID. Triggered this generate lead event. So, as you can see, very simple. You just go to import container, takes about 10 seconds, and the HubSpot form conversion tracking will be enabled. Now, of course, there are a few IDs which are specific. So, for example, after you import, you definitely want to go and make sure that the measurement ID is your measurement ID for the Google Analytics 4 event. So the events end up in your Google Analytics and not in mine. But it's just one or two copy pastes, and the setup does all of the rest. Now, there are few really amazing features, kind of which the other setups often neglect, and I'm gonna explain those. The first part is that we actually get all the information about the form once it's submitted. So, for example, we get the form email, first name, last name, message, company, city, etc. So, let me demonstrate this. So, I'm actually going to add a new field to my form. So, I'm going to go with the state and region. Nice. Click update and publish. Okay, so I have now added the state to the form and I'm gonna submit the form again. So my Google Tag Manager setup is kind enough that it will list all of the form fields for you in this format, and you will be able to use this variable in Google Tag Manager and use it for any tags that you like. So, for example, because now I have the state added, I can very easily go to Google Tag Manager, make a new variable, choose the data layer variable, and then just copy paste here what was in the console here. So just want to copy paste like this. And after I submit the form, I can see in Tag Assistant that this variable, the state, was filled up with whatever the user fills up in the form. So this makes my setup really easy to use, but very flexible, because you don't just get the form submit, you actually get all the information they submitted. Another thing that makes this kind of really easy to use imported Google Tag Manager container setup really kind of better than the other setups or the tutorials is that the Google Ads has the enhanced conversion tracking enabled, and all the things have been kind of done for you. So my setup actually looks like this. It has to include user provided data from your website enabled, and it's including this extra variable, which is using the email from the HubSpot form to make your conversions more accurate. Now, these are quite tricky and very kind of technically complicated to set up yourself, but with my setup, as it's just the one file that you will import, all of these will be set up for you, and you'll be all set for kind of the best, latest way to track conversions in Google Ads. Let's take a look at Metapixel. So for Metapixel, there are two events that kind of could be a good standard event for the HubSpot form submit: the contact and the lead. So there is a list of events for Meta, and we can send any of these events. Now, obviously, something like initiate, checkout, or purchase, or probably schedule won't fit very well. But the lead is a very good event for a new lead, obviously. And the contact event is another kind of appropriate event. So, because you may want to choose what is appropriate for you, my setup includes both of these. And it's automatically going to be using your Metapixel that you have already installed, so you don't even need to define the pixel ID to make this work. But I'm going to demonstrate this. Okay, let's submit the form one more time. Submit. And go to Events Manager, which is kind of like the real-time view for Google Analytics 4, but for Metapixel events. So here we see these two events, the contact event and the lead event. So another thing that is currently enabled for my Google Tag Manager HubSpot form conversion tracking setup is the deduplication. So because I have submitted so many kind of test bookings, contact lead, for the same form, with my setup, these kind of duplicates are automatically removed using the Facebook Pixel deduplication, because the ID that we send with the form kind of makes that possible. So it's possible to turn that off, but in most cases, I think this is a good idea because only the first form submit is usually valuable. Either way, as you can see, the contact and the lead events are being tracked, and there are a few parameters which we can use depending on which of these two events you want to go for. And I'm just adding something that will tell you what it is, what kind of contact this was, because it could be a phone call, it could be text message, WhatsApp, whatever. For the lead, that's also the case. Now, for the lead, it's possible to include a conversion value. Now, usually for HubSpot forms, as it's not like an e-commerce transaction, we may not be sure what is the exact value. However, if you want to, for example, in the end of the year, see your kind of rate, how many people who submitted the lead form became a customer, and what's the average customer lifetime value, for example, you could put that here and set your currency. Now, this is also true for the Google Analytics event. So for the Google Analytics generate lead, it's also possible very easily to add something like this, add the currency and add the value, if you know this. All right, so to recap, I'm a specialist for the HubSpot conversion tracking. I honestly do it better than anyone else. Most of the tutorials I read online make me cringe because how bad the methods are and how problematic they are. So you can hire me to track your HubSpot form conversions, or you can now buy this kind of imported file, just import it to a Google Tag Manager, follow the instructions that are included, and get your HubSpot form conversions tracked. If you have any experience in Google Tag Manager, you will be able to do this, probably even if you don't. So, cool. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll try one of my products or services for the HubSpot form conversions, and see you next time.